Hi, it's Eng Si Vian here. Welcome to the Tax Saving Tips for Small Business Part 2. In this video, I'm going to share with you more tax saving tips to help you to minimize your tax liability for this financial year. There are some smart strategies that you may want to consider for your situations before the end of the financial year. But don't leave it too late to plan, because if you leave it after 30 of June, then some of the tax tips that I'm about to share with you might be too late to apply. So I know you have been working hard the whole year and have been busy making money in your business, and you might not have time to get your financial organized. But now is actually the time for you to really do something, like you have to take action now, because you need to know how much money you actually make so far. So what I want you to do is like get your books and records up to date. Maybe get your accountant to help you to get your profit and loss accounts done up to date. And then maybe estimate to 30 of June. And then estimate your tax liabilities now, because you need to know where your financial position is in order for you to plan. And you also need to know like what exactly that you want to achieve. Because if you want to have the financial freedom, and that's why you are in business, right? Then knowing how to legally reduce your tax would, you know, get you to your goal more faster. Because if you pay more tax than you have to, then you're actually destroying your wealth. So you need to plan, and you have to be proactive, and you need to take action now. So in this video, I'm going to show you a few strategies that is available to you. But some of the strategy might not be right for you, because you need to have the right strategy that tailor to your specific needs. But it's good to have this sort of knowledge, because that means that you, if you have this sort of financial knowledge, then you are actually in control. So if your accountant actually tells you that it's nothing that you can do to reduce your tax, then you can actually ask, you know, what about this? What about that? So you can ask the right questions, and this may be open up in opportunities for you, okay? So the tax savings tip that I'm going to share with you in this video, it's basically allow you to buy more time. Because I will show you how you can actually legally defer your income to next financial year, like to bring forward some of the business expense. So, you know, if you can actually defer your income to next financial year, then you actually have the whole next financial year to plan. And then you can actually buy more time. And then you can actually have more time to implement some of the wealth creation strategies that help you to minimize your tax. Because by deferring your income to next year, we are not actually solving your problems yet, because you're just buying more time. So you need to actually do a proper financial plan, like strategy plan, to actually help you to minimize your tax. Because what I don't want you to do is like towards this time, there probably be a lot of investment or projects available out there that telling you that, you know, if you invest in this, you can get tax deductions now. But you have to remember, you don't put the tax, minimizing your tax, as your priority. You have to think, okay, if you're going to invest in this, whatever the project is, you want to actually make money. Because at the end of the day, say if you pay $100,000 to get a tax deduction now, then what you actually save is just whatever the tax rate that apply to you. Say your tax rate is 40%, you're actually saving $40,000. But what if you actually lost that $60,000? Then, you know, isn't it better that you actually just pay tax? So this is the sort of thing that you have to be careful. Don't just go into investment just to save tax, okay? Because that should be your second priority. But the strategies that I'm about to share with you is actually virtually, we're just going to defer the income to next financial year. So then we actually have more time to plan. Because, you know, tax planning should be done early, and you should put in actions over the entire year. And it's not like, because now it's June, and to do this is some of the strategies that you want to implement is actually take the whole year. And you need to really have a proper financial plan to put in, to have a proper financial plan to put in place to help you to actually achieve your goals, whatever that is, okay?
So the next expense is accrued expense. As you know, a lot of small business, you might pay your employee wages maybe weekly, fortnightly, or maybe monthly. But the day that it might probably fall, for example, to the 22nd of June. So, and then the next pay would be probably for after, probably in July. But what you can do is that you can actually accrue for that expense. So you can work it out, like from 22nd of June to the 30th of June, how much my accrue wages expense to be. And you can actually claim that part. Like you can actually accrue and claim that part. And same as, for example, if you actually decide that you're going to pay bonus to your employee, if you actually commit to pay that bonus to your employee, then you can actually accrue that expense and you claim that expense first, but you don't really have to physically pay that bonus to your employees yet. So from the employee's point of view, from their personal tax return, they don't have to declare their bonuses yet because they haven't actually received from you yet. But from your book, you can actually claim that expense. And the same for director's fees. If you're operating as a company, then you have you are the director of a company. So what if you have a very good year, you have a very good profit, then what you can do, you can actually declare, have the resolutions, have the minutes, and have the proper paperwork to declare that the company is actually commit to pay you the director's fee. And say, you know, you can pay yourself, say, $50,000, right? But what it is like the company can actually claim that director's fee. But you, as a personal tax return, you don't have to put that as your income yet. So that's actually a benefits there, and you can actually reduce your company's tax. So another thing is commissions, the same thing. Repairs and maintenance, you can accrue. Legal fees, advertising, gas and electricity, telephone, tax agent and accountant fees. So all these, as long as you got the invoice received before 30th of June, even though you haven't paid for it, but you got the invoice, you can actually claim for it. So if you really want to reduce your tax and really, you know, minimize that tax, then I suggest you to have a look at these things and then you can actually bring forward those expenses. Okay? Okay. Next is like debtors. What you can do is that I understand a lot of small businesses probably have a lot of debtors, but what you can do is that review all your debtors, you know, the age debtors, to see which debts that you can actually, you actually think that you cannot recover. Like it's actually can write off as a bad debt. If you can write off as a bad debt, then write off as a bad debt, then you get the deductions up front. So review your debtors and physically write off that debt. And if it's actually later on you actually recover that debt, you can actually put that back a successful income. But this is a very good strategy that you can take the opportunity to do that as well. And another thing is the trading stock. With the stock on hand, yes, you have to do physical stock take, but there's a different valuation for the stock value that you can actually put in your profit and loss account. So there's a three methods that you can actually value your stock. One is cost, the other one is market selling value, and then the third one is replacement price. Normally people will use cost because whatever that brings the lowest stock value, that's what you use, because closing stock is very important, because depending on how much stock that you declare in your profit and loss account will affect your gross profit margin and also the gross profit as well. And that will determine your net profit to actually, the net profit is the one that you actually end up going to be paying the tax. So stock is very important to look at that as well.